Hello, I'm Dr. Theodora Kalentzi, British Menopause Society accredited menopause specialist at Medical Prime Clinic.
And I'm Dr. Ashlesha Dhairyawan. I'm also a British Menopause Society accredited menopause specialist, also at Medical Prime. And today we're both happy to be here with you to celebrate World Menopause Day.
Indeed, this is really exciting because each year on the World Menopause Day, there is a particular focus on a health issue. And this year's focus is on cardiovascular health.
It's a really important topic, isn't it? Because it's not something that we always associate with menopause.
That's true. And talking about that, in your experience, what is the number one question that women ask you when they look into what is the risk of death after the menopause?
A lot of women come in, actually, and they think that's actually breast cancer, and they're really worried that breast cancer is the number one cause of death. But it actually isn't. Surprisingly, it's actually cardiovascular disease. Did you know that?
Well, that's interesting you say, because I have had a lot of talks and presentations recently, and there are figures quoting that this is even 10 times more common than breast cancer.
And I've even heard that it's even 13 times, actually, so it depends where you're reading, but it's definitely more common than breast cancer.
That's really, really very, very interesting to share with our patients. But I wonder if we can explain a little bit about what is cardiovascular disease, because that is a term we understand as doctors, but what about our women out there?
So I guess it's something that encompasses a lot of things, actually. So things like blood pressure, heart attacks, strokes, you know, all of that encompasses in the term cardiovascular disease.
And what are the main events that they usually associate with?
So, you know, heart attacks, strokes. And we know actually it's in menopause, it's actually the decline in estrogen that actually causes an increased risk of heart disease.
And what can women do to reduce the risk of having heart attacks and strokes?
I mean, it's very important actually, because the lifestyle is very important to think about. So, you know, things like trying to reduce smoking or stopping smoking, because that can have a significant risk of heart disease. Also other things like diet, you know, try to reduce things like salt intake and saturated fats, trying to increase exercise and maintain weight, those kind of things. Can you think of anything else, Theodora?
Well, what about this alcohol?
Yes, very true, especially on Menopause Day, you might want to celebrate, but as everything in moderation is very important.
Absolutely, indeed. And we usually say that every woman is different. We all experience the menopause in our unique way. And of course, we all have our own risks. They are based on our lifestyle choices, but they can also be other factors such as family history, etc. So if there are more questions or concerns about cardiovascular disease and risk for our individual patients, what would you advise them?
And I would definitely say to come and speak to a menopause specialist, especially at Medical Prime, to try and tailor, you know, management and individual treatment, because we know that hormone replacement in terms of estrogen can be very beneficial to try and reduce the risk in postmenopausal years.